Every month we get a ton of great new mobile games, and every month GameRanks puts together a list with what we consider to be the best ones. Hi folks, it's Falcon, and today on GameRanks, the 10 best free iOS and Android games of April 2020. At number 10, we're starting off with Disorder, a new multiplayer shooter with a lot of different modes and a lot of different options. Now, this is a team-based shooter that does have a lot of different character classes, so you might be thinking Overwatch, and in some respects, you're kind of correct. You do have to squad up, and it is wise to have people who understand the roles of the characters who are using them intelligently. However, the modes aren't all just that. The main mode is ULF, which is sort of a combination of a few different things, namely Battle Royale, Capture the Flag, and a deathmatch. Now, of course, like I said, it's squad-oriented, so you and your team are basically attempting to capture respawn points as you head to the center of the map where the main objective is. If you're not into that, there's also base battle and multi-base battle. It's pretty good, actually, as far as what options you have for playing. And although the visuals are a little bit generic, it is actually an incredibly fun game that I think you'll find is more than worth your time. Disorder is available on iOS and Android now. At number 9 is Naruto Slugfest. This is a 3D open world action MMORPG based on Naruto. I mean, there's a million Naruto games, and this is actually a fairly unique one. It is, like I said, a 3D MMORPG, and it's fun to see people Naruto running around. It's actually a fairly interesting idea, the way they've structured it. Some of it actually kind of comes off fairly linearly once you're in some missions, and I think that that's interesting. But one thing I do have to say, they've done a really good job making it look like an anime. It does a good job with the cel shading, and the environments are definitely very consistent with the proper style. Now, one complaint I have is that the on-screen controls are a little bit busy. But, on the other hand, I think you will find that the game itself is actually quite enjoyable once you get used to that. Now, there's a large amount of stuff you can do with friends. There's a family system, marriage system, team quests, apprenticeship. I mean, there's a lot to do. And it gives you a lot to explore as well. And I'm not going to say it's particularly innovative in every single aspect, but it keeps you busy in a way that I think you'll probably actually enjoy. It seems like everything's always new, at least as long as I've played it, which is admittedly not 40 hours or anything, but Naruto Slugfest is out on Android. It will be out on iOS soon. At number 8 is Dirt Bike Unchained, brought to us by the Red Bull Media House, so obviously, we know that it involves the Red Bull athletes. Still, this is actually a pretty exciting motocross game. It's got very good graphics, a lot of different bikes, and it really does a good job sort of differentiating between certain things. I mean, it's a mobile game, so you don't always really get that, and it's also developed, again, by an energy drink company's video game studio. But it's surprisingly fun and addicting. I really got into it. It's not the most complex thing I've ever played, and I'm not going to try to sell it as such, but it is a really fun game. Dirt Bike Unchained is out on iOS and Android now. Give it a roll. At number 7 is Aura Kingdom 2, a sort of remake of the PC game from 2014. Not a full remake, there's a lot different, but it's kind of an update on that concept. If you're interested, you can go back to Steam, check out Aura Kingdom. But I found this to be perfectly adequate. This is a MMORPG. It's a bit early days, but there's not really a lot of problems with it. The community is actually good. It's maybe a little bit small, but that can obviously be rectified over time. I say this with a lot of MMORPGs. There's not really a lot innovative about it. But the reason we picked this one is it's one that actually seems to manage to continue to be interesting to play over time. And number 6 is Legends of Runeterra, a new card game set in the world of League of Legends. If you've been playing Gwent, it will probably feel at least a little similar to you. It's not quite as complicated. There are only 2 tiers where you can place cards. However, for the most part, if you're able to play Gwent, I think you'll probably easily be able to take this on. I mean, there's a number of other card games that operate in a very similar fashion, but I just think that people who have been playing Gwent recently, since it's also been expanded to phones, probably will have an easy time with this. The goals are pretty much what you would expect: collecting cards, using cards, leveling up cards, creating strategies. It's a good game. Honestly, Legends of Runeterra actually takes a pretty good concept, simplifies it a bit, and gives you something that works really well. Legend of Runeterra is out on iOS and Android right now. At number 5 is Blade Axe Lord, a new hero-collecting, yes, gacha RPG, with a good command-based battle system and a lot of cutscenes. Like, the first while you play this game is going to feel like you're watching a little bit too many cutscenes. It is worth it to get through this because it does move into a much more 3D real-time interactive experience with a, like I said, pretty darn good battle system that I found engaging. I like how it works. It's very simple. You've got 4 buttons. And I would say that the way the story progresses and things go on in this game is a little bit more along the lines of a Final Fantasy than your typical gacha game. It does have some of the trappings, like loot boxes and all of that, but I don't know if that's avoidable in a free gacha game at this point. I mean, it technically is avoidable. If I were a developer, I'd probably try to find some alternate means of making money than that, but it seems pretty much the standard, so whatever. At number 4 is Dino Squad Online Action. To call this game unique is actually kind of an understatement. It's very different for a PvP shooter that you can get on mobile. You are a dinosaur, and you have guns, and it's insane. I'm not gonna lie, I love Dino Squad just on the idea alone. The game itself is actually very fun, but I mean, I just heard about it. I was like, yes, let me do this. It lives up to the hype too. Like, this is a very fun, very hectic, interesting game with a lot of different dinosaurs that all do various different things. They have mounted weapons, but they also have a set of melee moves like biting or tail swinging, etc., etc. You will be shocked at how good this works. The maps are nice and big too, so there's tons of room and lots of different environmental obstacles for you to deal with, which keep the gameplay nice and varied. Honestly, this is a game I'd like to see on full consoles and on Steam. I don't really know how to put it other than that Dino Squad does it for me. Like, seriously, it's really fun. It's out on iOS and Android now. Definitely try it. Like I said, the idea alone makes it interesting, but the execution is great. And number 3 is Gameloft Classics 20 Years. This is really not something that seems normal to me. Gameloft was around before the smartphone was around. Like, they had games that you could get on dumb phones, and they were actually pretty good games, and they've been around for a long time, and now you can get most of those games in one place. Like, it has a bunch of really great puzzle games that I used to play on phones all the time, particularly Bubble Bash 2, but like, they even have some of the lesser known arcade action titles you get on like Nokia's, like Soul of Darkness, which Soul of Darkness is just a fantastic Metroidvania with a lot of really cool ideas. It was a little bit slow paced, not necessarily as fast, but like, you have to keep in mind it was also a pretty non-advanced platform it was on. In truth, there are a ton of fantastic games in this one title, and this one title is free. The touchscreen controls work very well, might I add. Very easy, just up, down, left, right, X, Y, A, B. Really just a hell of a lot of fun. This will live on my phone for a very long time, because I will definitely return to a lot of these titles. Gameloft Classics 20 Years is out on Android now. Hopefully we'll see it on iOS as well, but anybody with an Android, you got some fun ahead. At number 2 is Game of Thrones Beyond the Wall, which is a game in which you command the Night's Watch in an original Game of Thrones story. That is directly what it is telling you it is. I'll say basically, if you're interested in gacha RPGs and also Game of Thrones, and actually goes for something that you probably wouldn't expect in a gacha RPG, instead of the more standard turn-based command-style stuff, it's the more Fire Emblem-y grid-based combat. I mean, it's still turn-based, still commands and all that. However, honestly, sometimes I really wish that there were more of these gacha RPGs that did go along those lines. Now, that's not to say I like one better than the other. I tend to really enjoy the command-based combat, whether it's on a grid or simply just turn-based with different characters. Now, beyond that, this is a fairly standard gacha. It's got an okay story. It's a pretty good-looking game. But really what I think is most valuable about it is the combat system. If you want to play a gacha with a Fire Emblem combat system and want some familiar characters that allow you to sort of enjoy something from a big IP like Game of Thrones, this is it. They've done this extremely well, if not, like I tend to say with gacha games, not necessarily super innovative. Still, it's a load of fun. It's out on iOS and Android now. Check it out. And at number one, it's Dead by Daylight Mobile, which is an interesting port of the asymmetrical survival horror game that actually does a really good job of bringing it to the phone. It's not really something that I personally would have thought, yeah, that's something I want to play on mobile, but this version of it actually really works. The touch controls are responsive and uncomplicated, and the gameplay is preserved really well. I really enjoy this version of the game. If you're at all a fan of asymmetrical PvP, this is probably your best bet on mobile right now. It's a really good version of this game. Dead by Daylight Mobile is out on iOS and Android right now. Also, I have got a quick bonus game for you. It's called Gris. It is a pay game, a beautifully animated platform adventure game that came out during the second half of last year on various platforms and has finally landed on Android this month. Now, other people have played this game. It's a beautiful, beautiful game. A very clever game that is very interesting, very well-designed levels, and like I said, the art design is incredible. It's worth the $5. I love Gris. It's a great game. That's all for this month. Which game did you like the best? Leave us a comment. Let us know what you think. If you enjoyed this video, please click like. If you're not subscribed, now's a great time to do so. We upload brand new videos every day of the week, and the best way to see them first is, of course, a subscription. So click subscribe, and do not forget to enable all notifications. As always, we thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Falcon. You can follow me on Twitter, @FalconTheHero. We'll see you next time right here on GameRanks.